Let's today I will discuss the basics of JavaScript with you. So let us begin that first of all, as you have already studied Java, so let us see that what is the difference between Java and JavaScript. So as you can see here, Java is a strongly typed language, whereas you already studied that JavaScript is a weak. Now in Java, you are using the concepts of object-oriented programming languages. Whereas in JavaScript, as you are having scripting, it is called an object-based scripting language. Now, Java code, you need a JVM or any other virtual machine to run or even browser. Whereas in JavaScript, you can run it only on the browser. Again, the extensions are different. And also, Java was a standalone. Whereas JavaScript, you will need HTML. You need to incorporate your page inside an HTML page. Otherwise, you won't be able to do scripting. In JavaScript, again, is an event-based approach. You will be going through various events like mouse events, keyboard events, etc. We'll see that in the upcoming slides. Now, first of all, what is JS? So, JS is a client-side scripting language. And you have already heard that PHP is a server-side scripting language. Now, if you want to enhance the interaction between the user and a web page, then mainly JavaScript is used. Initially, JavaScript was called LabScript, but it was later renamed after Java as JavaScript. Now, there are three core technologies of World Wide Web, and these three core technologies are HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. We have already studied HTML, CSS, and so now we are starting with the third core technology, that is JavaScript. Now, what makes JavaScript unique? Because it is having full integration with your HTML and CSS page. Secondly, that it is very simple to code in JavaScript. And the third point is that it is supported by majorly all the browsers that you are using. So whenever you run a JavaScript code, if you are not having Node.js, right? So you don't have to create a .js file, but you just have to create a .html file, and that JavaScript file will run in your browser because your browser supports it. Now, what are the advantages of JavaScript? So it is having less server interaction as it is a client's server-side scripting. It's not a server-side scripting language. Next is immediate feedback to its all the visitors. There is increased interactivity. Also, you are having more richer interfaces. You are having events, effects, right? When you study the jQuery library of JavaScript, you will study about certain effects also. Now, let us go to the limitations. Now, this client-side scripting language JavaScript will not allow reading or writing of files, okay, because it is client-side. Next thing is that cannot be used for networking applications because no such support is available. Now, how do you first code a JavaScript? So, here is the syntax. You need to write your code inside the script tag. Now, there are two important attributes that you will be using. One is language and the second is type. You will soon be seeing a simple code on how to write JavaScript. So language will specify the scripting language that you are using. So as you can see here, script language equals to JavaScript. Now inside type, you have to indicate that what is recommended for this scripting. So text file and JavaScript. Then you will write a JS code and then script. And the script tag will come in your HTML tag. Now here is an example. Right? Inside your HTML tag, you are having head, a title, then script type equals to text JavaScript. Now, there are alert boxes, confirmation boxes, and prompt boxes available in JavaScript. So I am creating an alert box. So here is the syntax alert, and I write my message in this parenthesis. Now, when I run this code, here is my code. So on click, I have given an event, which is called on click. So here I have created a button. So when I click on this button, I get an alert box. So I'll run this code. Okay, so as you can see here, this is my title, JavaScript alert. Now when I click on this button, so I have given an on click event. So as I click on this, I get an alert box, which says I am an alert box. So this is how you do simple scripting in JavaScript. So now what are the characteristics of JavaScript? So there are white spaces and line breaks. Semicolons are optional. Next thing, JavaScript is very case sensitive. Also now the comments. So comment style is of C and C++. Now data types. So again you are having number, strings, boolean, null, undefined types of data types, and further you can also create JavaScript objects. So next let's look at the variables. Again, this is similar to what you were doing in Java C or C++. Now you can declare variable using the var keyword. So inside the script tag you can specify what your variable is, like variable a, b, c, etc. So here is an example. You can see here that here variable a equals to 10, the value has already been given. So to assign value to a variable, you have to use an equal to sign. You can assign the value during the time of declaration, or you can redeclare it later. Like you can directly assign as variable a equals to 10, or you can just write variable a and then you can write the value. So there are certain naming conventions for these JavaScript variables. As you can see that there are rules for constructing names of variables. You need unique identifiers for that. Your variable name can contain letters, digits, underscores, and even dollar signs. It must always begin with a letter. Now, the whatever name you give can also begin with dollar and underscore. Then you are having names are case sensitive. So if you declare variable small y and variable capital Y, both are called different variables. Now there are certain reserved words like keywords. So you cannot name a variable as JavaScript. That cannot be used as a variable name.